Hey friends, I'm Alex from CarryOnTourism.com. This is our sign, we just got it, and I'm proud. Today, I want to talk about packing. This is my travel backpack, and I want to talk about my carry-on as well. Travel backpack, this is an Eagle Creek cargo hauler, 45 liter. 45 liters are a really good size for you to focus on because that is absolutely maximum carry-on capacity for your plane, and you don't want to check a bag. Too much risk that doesn't get there and ruins your vacation. And 45 liters is 9 by 22 by 14 inches, which is where you want to be. There's no wheels on the bottom, and if you have the strength to carry this bag, I recommend you do it. Not a huge fan of this brand in particular, but it's kind of cool. Also, I put some carabiners on here because I like to be able to do this, which is to clip one side to my carry-on bag here. And then I sewed, actually with a needle and thread, a little strap over here. And I like to clip it over here so I can be hands-free while I walk through the airport. It's a little dorky, but I think it's worth it. This is my favorite carry-on bag. It's been lots of places, and I put patches on it because I think it's fun. So I'm gonna take that off and talk about what I'm gonna wear on the plane. These are the shoes I'm gonna wear on the plane. This is a hiking product from the brand of running shoe that I really like. That's actually New Balance for me. Doesn't have to be for you. These, this shirt and these pants are from Eddie Bauer. They're very light, they're very wicking. I'm gonna talk about that in a minute. And these underwear and shirt are very light, very wicking, something that you can wash in the sink and will dry overnight with relatively low humidity. This is Ex Officio. There's other products, including these socks. Notice that I'm wearing long pants, even though we're going for a 2-week trip to China, because in a lot of places it's not really appropriate to wear shorts. An Italian cathedral is a good example. A Chinese monastery is another one. And if you want to visit one of those, you're going to want to have long pants and sleeves that at least come to here. So let's talk now about my carry-on. This is a pickpocket-proof product. You'll notice that there's like a cute little clip in here that goes to kind of this fastener. And that allows you to not get pickpocketed. This is a good idea for places like Rome or China, where we're going. By the way, we packed for 2 weeks, so everything you see is something that we're taking for 2 weeks.
Show me that one more time, the clip.
Okay, this little clip. This product comes from Travelon. There's also a company called PackSafe that makes a pretty good product, and it makes sure that you don't get that pickpocketed. And then everything inside, there's actually another interior pocket here where you can put valuables and make sure they don't get pickpocketed. Of course, the real secret to not getting pickpocketed is to have a money belt inside your pants, which looks like this. So keep one of those with your passport, your large quantity of money inside your pants. I also like to carry a picnic kit. This is a little like polyurethane sort of fork, knife, spoon combo. This is a good thing to take if you're gonna buy food on the road. And I choose to have a bottle opener and a corkscrew with me, which is what that is. This is my guidebook. DK Eyewitness Travel is a good brand. I like Fodor's as well. Rick Steves, anything in Europe. And this is something that you always take when you travel internationally because there is not always toilet paper where you go. This is a backup battery that I'm taking because I'm going to have a GoPro with me. And this is my electronics kit. Has a charger in it. I like this one because it has 4 ports. I also travel with a GoPro, so you'll see some of this in the future. And then I have some headphones that I'll use on the plane. And one thing that I like to carry is a headphone splitter so that Christy and I can listen to the same movie at the same time, which is something that we like to do, especially on very long flights. And China is a very long flight. And this is my decoy wallet. I'll carry this in my back pocket so that if it gets pickpocketed, nothing important is missing. It actually has 20 pesos. That's like a $1. And I carry a Sharpie with me. That's pretty useful, comes in handy. Glasses case because I carry prescription sunglasses. In this pocket, I have hand sanitizer, nice in bathrooms where you don't have a place to wash your hands. Coins are more valuable outside the US than they are here, so a little coin purse can be useful. I like to have a little notebook. This one's kind of fun because it has fun pictures of things that are important in Utah. And I like to be able to show people a little map of where we live in case they've seen a map but they haven't heard of Utah. So we talked to some Norwegians at a soccer game in Italy one time, and that was pretty fun. And then over here, I have a little first aid kit, kind of a silicon-based glide, acetaminophen, ibuprofen, an antacid, lots of Band-Aids, Pepto-Bismol, there's some Benadryl here in case of allergy, and I think I have a couple of safety pins there in case someone clothes are trying to break off. I carry a carabiner on this backpack, which is useful in case you're on a train and you're worried about it getting stolen. You can carabiner the bag to itself around a pole on the train that you're in so that no one can steal it while you go through a dark tunnel. That can be useful. You go through the outside pockets. This is a folding duffel so that when you bring more clothes on the way back, like you bought a bunch of sweatshirts for your kids, you don't have to buy an extra bag. If you have ever bought a bag in Vegas on the Strip or in an airport or in the hotel, it's very, very expensive. So this has been nice. This bag's been all over the world. This is actually my document folder. If you're looking for something like this, look for an expanding file. I got this at the container store. It's not very expensive. And it has everything that we're going to need for the whole trip. All of our maps, all of our hotels, everything written in Chinese in case we need to show it to a taxi driver, a little bit of foreign currency, copies of our passport on paper, which can be really helpful if you lose yours, information about our flight, information about our trains. We're going to take a lot of trains on this trip, so that can be helpful to have that in paper just in case something goes wrong. This pocket is actually my toiletry kit, so nothing special here, you know, face wash, razors, shaving cream, deodorant, aftershave, a little Tide to go because I'll be doing laundry in the sink as I go, my razor. I carry a flashlight because that can be useful, a little bit of prescription stuff in case you need that. I have a Ambien if you have problems sleeping, face lotion, cologne, that sort of stuff. These are my vitamins, not something you can buy overseas, so you're going to want to bring that with you. These are fun. You can bring these through TSA, you can drink them in the airport, you can take them on the plane, you cannot serve yourself on the plane, so be careful with that, but that's what the law says. And opening the bag here, this is Christie's toiletry kit. This is really useful because it's pretty compact and it has this cool hanger. You may end up in a place that does not have a lot of counter space in your bathroom, so this is super useful. And then inside, she has her curling iron blow dryer. These are dual voltage so that you can use them overseas. And then this is all the stuff she needs. Nice, has a little mirror. This is again an Eagle Creek product. And the nice thing about the Eagle Creek products is that they're designed to fit inside a max size carry-on bag. So the width of this bag is 14 inches, the width of this packing cube is 14 inches, and we're huge fans of packing cubes in our family, mostly because it allows you to put a lot of stuff in here so that it's a lot of pressure, it's packed really tight, this thing is like a brick, and then when you open your bag, it doesn't explode here, it explodes here, so you can take out what you need. I'll go through this briefly. Sun hat that I like, fun Chinese shirt with a joke nose, and my pants are made out of a material that dries really quickly, kind of a polyurethane, polyester mix. Take the stuff you have at your house and hang it up in the sink and see how fast it dries, because that can be really useful. Again, I'm going to China for 14 days with 4 pairs of underwear. I will be washing clothes regularly throughout the whole trip. These are Christie's shoes. It's a nice walking shoe. We're going to be in hot weather. This is what she's going to be wearing, and I have that in my bag. These are some of Christie's toiletries. It packs really tight, so she has all of her stuff in here, and it's really, really easy for her to pack that really
Eagle
really
Creek.
Close.
That's Eagle Creek, not
yeah.
Eagle.
It's an Eagle Creek product. Is that what I said? This, again, is another Eagle Creek product. This is the packing cube, and these are half the size of this big one, so it fits two of them in the size where one of those is. And this has, again, my pajamas. I like to roll my underclothing like this so that it fits in there really nice and tight, so that should be easy for everybody. This is my utility kit. It's basically all the little extras that I feel like I need. This has some super glue, some duct tape, rubber bands, zip ties, lots of Ziplocs. more Band-Aids. These are the bigger ones, the kinds that you'd put on your foot if your shoes are bothering you. And when you're traveling, you're going to be doing a lot of walking, so that can be nice. This is my clothesline. It has a clip on each end. The nice thing about this twisted nylon cord is that you take the clothes and you just kind of stuff one little corner of your shirt in here, and when it pulls tight, it holds it, so you don't need extra clothing pins. Again, more of these because you'll be needing those. This is kind of a camping wipe, sort of like a grown-up diaper wipe, so that if you are on a train in China, for example, and there is no shower, you have a way that you can wash yourself. I'll be using that, and that's about all that's in there. And we already talked about what's in here. Oh yeah, document folder. And that's it, that's everything we're carrying. So I don't like to check a bag on the way there. I might check a bag on the way back because there's not as much risk if a bag doesn't make it to home. But on the way there it is. And this is Alex from Carry On Tourism.